the identifying data, Lizzie, a 4-year-old girl from Las Pinas, and she was brought to OPD for the first time with the chief complaints of poor weight gain and pale appearance, a history of present illness. There is no symptoms of fatigue, no increase in sleep time, no exercise intolerance, no changes in stool color, quality and frequency, no black or tarry toes. With a family history, father is a hypertensive patient and there is no history of splenectomy, gallstones at early age and other anemia in family. Immunization history. Complete immunizations was given to the child from the local health center. Personal and social history. Her mother is a laundry woman. Father is a carpenter. She has 2 older siblings of 6 and 8 years old. As a doctor, I will be asking a few more questions that help me to come up with my diagnosis. The questions are, what are her regular habits? And have she taken any previous medications? As a mother told, there is a problem within the poor weight gain. So I will be asking, when did you realize that she had a poor weight gain? And about the meals per day. Then the questions will be regarding a 4-year child can do. The questions are like, can she build a castle on her own? And I will be asking the child to name the color and shape of her object. Then the questions is like, how many hours your child spent in playing per day? Then moving on with the maternal history, was Lizzie a preterm or a full-term baby? And until what month was Lizzie breastfeed? And was your child Lizzie given any non-formula, cow's milk, soy milk or goat's milk before 12 months of age?
Let us move on to the physical examination of our patient. The vital signs are, she is afebrile, her blood pressure is normal, her pulse is increased, that is mild tachycardia, her respiratory rate is decreased, that is bradycardia. Lizzie's height and weight are decreased than the normal age group. Her general appearance is pale, which indicates decreased blood supply to the skin, which may be due to anemia. She is active and not in respiratory distress. On physical examination, her conjunctiva is pale, which can be due to anemia. Lizzie has dental caries. This can be found in children who eat a lot of sugar and candies, and when bacteria proliferate on their teeth, it gets decayed. Mild tachycardia and soft murmurs can be physiologic in children. Chest, abdomen and rectal examinations are unremarkable in our patient.
Next, we are moving on with the salient features. These are the important points that make us to have a final diagnosis. These are 4-year-old female, picky eater, poor weight gain, pale appearance, presence of soft murmur, mild tachycardia, pale conjunctiva and dental caries. Based on the history and physical examination, our initial impression is anemia.
Let us look into the lab interpretation of our patient. The white blood cell count is normal. Hemoglobin and hematocrit decreased, which points to anemia. Platelet count is elevated, which could be due to reactive thrombocytosis, infection, inflammation or iron deficiency. Mean corpuscular volume is decreased, which indicates microcytic anemia due to iron deficiency. This can be due to decreased dietary iron intake. Decreased REW could be due to iron deficiency anemia. The report of the peripheral blood smear suggests that our patient is having microcytosis, hypochromia, mild anisocytosis, and polychromasia. The suggested test for diagnosis for our patient are serum iron to measure the amount of iron in blood, serum ferritin to find out how much iron is stored in the body, serum total iron binding capacity to measure blood's capacity to bind iron with transferrin, evaluation for hemosiderinuria, hemoglobinuria and pulmonary hemosiderosis.
Let's look at the differential diagnosis. Looking at the physical examination and lab findings of our patient, we got the following differentials. Thalassemia intermedia is our first differential. Why intermedia? Because this is seen at the age of 2 to 4 years and our patient is 4 years old. Thalassemia comes under intrinsic defect of hemolytic anemia, which is subclassified under hemoglobinopathies, where hemoglobin has an abnormal structure. The clinical findings in our patient like pallor, hemic murmur, low hemoglobin, and other lab findings of microcytic, hypochromic, anisocytosis, polychromasia, poikilocytosis, and increased RDW of 21% on peripheral smear of our patient makes us to rule in thalassemia intermedia. The specific findings for this, like no jaundice, no history of fatigability, no irritability, no history of dyspnea on exertion, absence of hepatosplenomegaly, hemolytic facies, growth and developmental delays, and no history of thalassemia running in the families. Along with that, no lab findings of target cells, basophilic stippling, fragmented red cells, and Howell-Jolly bodies made us to rule out thalassemia intermedia as our diagnosis. Our second differential was sideroblastic anemia, which is seen rarely in girl child, but still our patient has low HB, microcytosis, hypochromic erythrocytes, and the physical findings such as pale conjunctiva, hemic murmur, tachycardia made us to rule in sideroblastic anemia as one of our differential. But the specific findings like a large ring sideroblast, absence of iron studies, and no family history of blood disorder made us to rule out sideroblastic anemia as one of our diagnosis. Our third differential is vitamin B12 deficiency. The history which says long stay on milk, peak eating, low hemoglobin, no balanced diet history, pallor made us to think that this could be the nutritional deficiency anemia which is present in our patient. But as there is no findings of neurological or psychological signs, no hepatosplenomegaly, no hyperpigmentation, absence of macrocytes, absence of megaloblast, no thrombocytopenia or neutropenia made us to rule out vitamin B12 deficiency anemia in our patient.
Final diagnosis. Our final diagnosis in this case is iron deficiency anemia. Now let's talk what is iron deficiency anemia. As the name implies, iron deficiency anemia means due to insufficient iron. Iron deficiency anemia is a common type of anemia, a condition in which blood lacks adequate healthy red blood cells and reduced oxygen supply to body tissues. As we know that hemoglobin, which is contained within the RBCs, carries oxygen to body tissues. Now, what causes iron deficiency anemia in children? First, the insufficient iron intake together with rapid growth during the childhood. Parasite infection, as here the child used to play in soil ground, so can be infected with hookworms. Dental caries, as many evidences suggest that children who comes up with severe dental caries comes up with iron deficiency anemia. GI blood loss, low birth weight, as preterm infants need more iron due to increased postnatal growth as compared to term infants. And excessive cow milk intake, as cow milk has 4 times more calcium as compared to human milk, which contribute to less iron absorption. Now, the ruling for iron deficiency anemia, that why we keep iron deficiency anemia as our final diagnosis. So here, pale appearance, mild tachycardia and soft murmurs, decreased hemoglobin, decreased hematocrit, decreased MCV, that is mean corpuscle volume, high RDW, red cell distribution weight, microcytosis, anisocytosis, polychromasia, hypochromasia, no basophilic stippling, which is generally seen with megaloblastic anemia, and poor weight and height. Now the pathophysiology. Because of the inadequate iron-rich food intake, which leads to decreased iron absorption in the GI system, and hence depletion of iron stores in the body. So that comes up with decreased iron reserve, and comes up with decreased hemoglobin and RBC production, and also with increased RDW, microcytosis, and hypochromasia. So that manifests with the iron deficiency anemia.
will manage the patient by giving iron supplements. Children diagnosed with iron deficiency anemia should be treated by oral ferrous sulfate for several months to increase iron levels in the blood. Iron supplements can irritate the stomach and discolor bowel movements, so they should be taken with the citrus juices to increase the absorption. If child can't take drops or pills, IV may be needed, but this is very unusual. The advice I would like to give to the parents is to provide the iron-rich diet. Eating a diet with rich foods can help treat iron deficiency anemia. Iron-enriched cereals, breads, rice, pastas, meats such as beef, pork, lamb, liver, and other organ meats, poultry such as chicken, duck, turkey and liver, fish such as shellfish, including clams, mussels, and oysters, sardines, leafy greens of cabbage family such as broccoli, kale, turnip green and collards, yeast leavened whole wheat bread and rolls, fruits and vegetables which contain vitamin C.